Deal.
From?
Crossfire Collectibles.
And in today's video, we are doing the G.I. Joe Mega Haul Part 3.
Super Mega Haul.
Super Mega Haul.
Part 3. All right. Kicking things off, we'll show you some random stuff up here. To start this off, I'm going to show you this three. I picked up two more at Walmart, one to keep in the box and one to keep for myself because he got the one that we showed before. I'm not going to show you the other one because you know they're here, but there's another one and I'm just going to go ahead and knock that out. I'll explain these. Stop by Gabe's and I saw a ton of these, the mini Forever Clever Lego type vehicles or building bricks, whatever you want to call. So we got the Ferret with Storm Shadow, the Fang with Cobra Commander, and the Ninja, what is it, Speed Cycle with Snake Eyes. So I'm still looking out for the Rattler. I want that one, but yeah. We'll get into some Lucy's real quick. I'm building up the Shock Troopers. So we got three more, and we got another Resolute bag. This one I got on Facebook Marketplace, and he doesn't come with everything. He's missing his claw, he's missing the blowtorch, his pistol, and his stand. But you know, for a like $40 or $50 figure, you know what they go for on eBay. I got him for like $20 shipped, so I was like, yeah, I'll take it, you know, because I have one that's missing his belt and holster. So I'll go ahead and let Hayden have it because he said he wants it. I don't know why, but I'll take the completed pieces that one had, put it with him, and this one will be complete. So that works.
Yeah, but you already know what they come with. For some reason, this one isn't going together right, so I'm not going to really worry about it. But you know, it's the figure. He comes with the helmet, the mask, the minigun, the sledgehammer, the gunchucks. A taser,
batons,
whatever, the shield, and the goggles, an assault rifle, and the walkie-talkie.
So I got one over here, and, okay, his walkie's on his back, because they all should be complete. I don't know what to give this one. I'm gonna give him a pair of machine guns. Be like, yeah, boy, what's up? Beep, beep, beep. He's like, I'm going to action. Who's with me? I didn't see what was what. I think they're all Pursuit of Cobra Shock Troopers, because none of the stands have the gold Cobra sigil on it. But that's fine. I mean, they're the same figure. It's just the difference is the stand. So throw all the extra weapons and junk back in the bags. Actually, I'm not gonna use this big bag. I'm gonna call small and small. Get that out of here. Take this.
Here's the other one, but.
Yeah, you get the idea. I'll put him out of the way. Okay, I found somebody selling some more 50 of 3-packs, and we went ahead and picked up these. For this, you get another Shock Trooper, because, you know, I said I'm going to build up my Shock Trooper army now. Now I got enough Cobra Troopers, and still getting some Vipers here and there, but whatever. I'm going to keep the Rock Viper, too, so I have three of them complete. And that's just what I do. I have, like, certain troop builders, I have three, 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 because they fill out my one shelf perfectly per level. So that works. And then the Shock Troopers. Alpine, a buddy of mine, wants. This pack, I'm not sure who wants what. These two will probably go on eBay, unless my buddy who's in Alpine wants this bazooka. And then Firefly, he sells for a few bucks.
I'll take the Dusty because I don't have one.
Dude, you got like five Dusties.
I don't have that one. Well, I have that one, but he's all like mixed up and arranged with other parts.
Yeah. And then the Cobra Legion 3-pack, got another one of these. And this one I got for $50, man. And because I want all three of these for troop builders. This will make technically my fourth. I have one of these packs already, but it's sealed. So I'm gonna open this and we can take these out and show them. And if you want to show them real quick while I pop this open, just show them the packs. Because they're not going to get opened yet, because I don't know who wants what yet. But likely they will be opened, and whoever, which one of my like friends don't want any, they'll go on eBay. So if you remember that I mentioned we have an eBay page, and just check out Crossfire Collectibles. That's our eBay page and our store. We don't sell off too much of the stuff that we show. We sell off a little bit, you know, extra things that we already have that we might get in lots and everything, but we got some stuff up, and I start everything usually pretty low, so just pop cards. Stands, you want to open them? Pop some figures out. And here, you get the Saw Viper. It came with that much stuff. Yeah, Cobra Legion Urban Bat. I'll let Hayden mess with him. Stands. And female Cobra Officer. So pop all this stuff out and show them off one by one. So he's got a little dagger. Stick in his back sheath. He also has one that's already in his front sheath. That doesn't want to come out. There we go. See, they glue them in there, I think, because it just peeled the paint off. I think my other ones did that too. I don't get it, but whatever. He's got some binoculars on the other side. They pop off. He's got this little tiny pistol here. I don't recall if that goes on his vest or not. I don't see a spot for it. Unless it goes to her. Unless she's got her pistols in her sheath. Alright, well. He's got his little heavy machine gun with the drum tank barrel and bipod. Helmet. What you going? And he's got this BFG. I think I have my other ones holding one of these, so I'm probably not going to use it. I'm gonna give him the pistol. I'm gonna be different because everybody's like, "Oh, it's a Saw Viper." You know, he's got to have this giant gun and everything. But, mix it up a little bit. Here's the bat. He comes with a flamethrower. I guess a drill flamethrower. It's a claw with a little saw, and he comes with a little pistol on the side. And then here's his normal other hand, and then his normal other hand is in his backpack, and also you can switch out the front plate from a broken one to a normal quick one. So I do have one Cobra Legion set loose that I picked up, and I picked up a Saw Viper you've seen in a past video from a toy lot when I've got some Night Vipers and some other things. He had one Saw Viper, so I was like, all right, yeah, I'll take him. And I was like, well, I have one of these sets, you know, still boxed. I try to keep one of everything boxed, you know, just in case. And I'll do all my troop building elsewhere. But every time a Saw Viper popped up, I really didn't want to pay $30 for it. So, but I got this for $50. So, I mean, yeah, it's like, you know, like almost $17 a piece.
And this does not fit.
So I was cool with that. Plus, I had a few of these loose. Someone wanted to buy them from me, and I actually sold a bunch, except for, I think, two. So I kept two. So here's the third one loose. And I only have one of that one. But I might customize it, paint the hair, like kind of how the other single figures are. I mean, the exclusive three packs that you could buy, like the female Night Stalkers or female, you know, Cobra Troopers, stuff like that. Show you the Saw Viper with his stand, holding the pistol and the machine gun. And I'll put the heavy gun, I'll just throw that on his back, because I think it pegs in. Just pop his big heavy artillery gun on his back, and the holding the other heavy machine gun, and his pistol ready to go.
So here she is. She has this giant backpack with some landmines on it, and she has this little assault rifle you can put in her hand. And fell. She comes with dynamite, I think.
Explosives.
She comes with a pistol and a silencer, a knife and a little sheath on her side. She comes with the RPG, and she comes with a helmet that doesn't like to fit her head, and here's that assault, and here's that rifle.
So there you go. Okay, so that'll take care of that part. And now for the main event. We've been saving this for last. So our main event is what we've been waiting to show you guys. I picked it up. It was missing a few pieces. But I ended up taking a little bit of extra long time because we got it like a month ago. But I didn't want to show it off in incomplete, basically. So if you will, grab the first piece. And like I said, I've been showing me, like giving hints in each videos. And we've had this sitting up, you know, there in case you guys wanted to see. Be like, oh, what's that? This would be the fantail deck of the G.I. Joe 1985 Vintage USS Flag aircraft carrier.
Yup.
So without further ado, here's the fantail, which is complete with the fantail railing and the radar. I forgot what that's called.
Radar dish?
No, it's this piece, arrestor or something? No, that's arrestor. Anyway, we gotta assemble it.
Antenna?
No, it's an antenna, yeah. But we have to assemble it, so it's gonna take a few minutes. So while we're doing our thing, we're gonna cut this so it doesn't waste your time, and we're gonna do it right here on the table. So we'll be back in a few minutes. So,
what's up, guys? We are back.
My back. Oh, my back.
I'm gonna put some dirt in your eye.
USS Flag is built.
Unfortunately, it's so damn big, and the table isn't really big enough, so we can't show you the entire thing. So what we'll do is we'll give you like a little panoramic area or view and show you some stuff right here. As you can see, the stern end, or the bow, which one is it?
That is the stern.
Yeah. The stern end with the fantail deck is right here. So our table kind of ended. We got the bow one up here, as you can saw in the picture. But yeah, this is pretty much it. So here's the fantail.
Boy, if you don't...
I'll move that aside. We got our little fuel tank and cart right here. We threw Jetfire Skystriker on here and hooked it up to the arrestor cables just because, and I brought out FSS keelhole. So basically show you like a kind of modernizing G.I. Joe issue with this. Yeah, the flag, it's 100% complete. I didn't put the deck clips in, but that's what this is right here. You know, filled with deck clips. So there's 16 slots for them. There's 16 deck clips in there. I did have more. I sold a couple off because I don't need them and I don't plan on putting them in there. But yeah, I had to get a reproduction elevator lift piece, which is this right here because the other one was snapped. So this is a repro and I like the design they gave it because it actually opens and closes. And you can just put that right back in the space. Somewhere over here. Hold the elevator up. Really cool. And you can see I got keelhaul right there next to the little rescue boat. So when I put that down, he's like, I need to get out of Dodge. And he's only shitting away he gives. So I'll put him back up in his little area with his admiral's chair and everything else. There's no 9-volt in the microphone, so we can't let you hear the sound for that. But yeah, apart from that, you know, everything. Everything's good. This is, again, you know, for being, what, 36 years old, it's pretty neat.
A mother lover can't see me.
Take the old flag off, pop out keel balls, and put that in there so you have, like, a USS flag on top of the flag. Three flags in the same sentence.
USS flag on the flag. A USS flag on the USS flag.
We had an issue, Jetfire out the way a little bit so you can see.
We moved that flag down from the USS flag and took this USS flag and put it.
The Y pins. His went in with no problem. I had to like kind of force mine in. I was really careful, but I don't want to break them. But Yeah, that's our USS flag. So this is actually going to go up for sale, unfortunately, because I don't have room for it. And so we did get this as part of a trade. I wanted to complete it, and now it's complete, and we're going to go ahead and list it and say bye-bye. So once we get a shop that's a little bit bigger in proper order, I'll go ahead and grab another one of these. I know somebody who has four of them, and they're selling all of them, and he doesn't plan on moving them anytime soon, but he's going to hook me up with one. So I will get that, and I'll get the other pieces I need for it, and we'll have another complete one. This is actually my second complete flag. The first one was, geez, like 14 years ago. And him was just a whittle guy. Him don't want Wimbo. But, yeah, that was in a lot more better condition than this one. This one has a few broke tabs on some of these pieces. You know, the ones that, like, hold it up and everything. But, that's pretty much it. You know, all the doors are good. Everything else, you know, nothing's broke, nothing's messed up, nothing's missing. Parts were missing, but like I said, I restored it and completed it all. I did have to get new tubes for the fuel tank. The other tube, it was a wreck, so I just got new tubes for that and threw the pumps on there. But besides that, everything's good to go. I'll probably set some figures up on it and get a couple shots before it gets disassembled and put back away, because we can't do anything with a 700 or 7.5 foot aircraft carrier sitting in the middle of the
thing. I ain't taking this apart.
It took a few minutes to put together, but you know, what do you expect? But yeah, so
if you guys did enjoy this video, make sure to giant thumbs up, subscribe to those bell notifications so you know when we post a video. Make sure to follow us both on Instagram at everything.gijoe,
Crossfire X Collectibles.
Check out our Facebook at HP Crossfire Collectibles. And check out our Patreon. It's only $1.
$1!
And we'll see y'all in the next one. Peace.
Peace.